recall the definition of NP hardness, you say a problem is NP hard, say problem X is NP hard if there exists a polytime reduction from every problem in NP to X. So if we come up with a polytime reduction from problem Y in NP to X, then X is NP hard. And such a reduction is for each problem in NP. And if there are say 5000 problems in NP, then we have to give 5000 reductions to problem X. This way problem X is NP hard. So what is this telling us? It says problem X is at least as hard as every other problem in the set NP. Okay. And X is the oddest problem in NP. So there are so many problems and we were able to relate some of them. A fundamental question is there a difficult problem in NP? And are there difficult problems in NP? Which is the oddest problem in NP? Difficult, oddest, they all mean one. Which is the oddest problem in NP? And why do we need to find such a thing? So the idea is this. If the oddest problem belongs to class P, then every problem in NP has a deterministic polytime algorithm, or every problem in NP belongs to class P, which means P equals NP. So that's the idea. So as on this date, we are unable to find deterministic polynomial time algorithms for many problems. And so that's when we introduced this non-deterministic power. And then we started designing non-deterministic algorithms. And that gave us the set NP. And the set is growing. And there are many problems in NP. Then we started asking, can we relate the relative hardness of these problems? Can we say this problem is at least as hard as this problem? That's when we were able to come up with polynomial time reduction or reducibility between combinatorial problems. We were able to relate 3-sat and click and independent set and vertex cover and so on. And now with this theory, NP hardness theory, you see that here is the oddest problem. You solve the difficult problem in polynomial time, every other problem in the set NP becomes class P. Every other problem in NP belongs to the class P. And so to talk about this idea, the theory of NP hardness was discovered. Okay. Now, which is the first NP hard problem and how are these problems related? All that we shall see next. The fundamental question is this, which is the first NP hard problem discovered in the literature. There are two scientists by name Cook and Levin. So they have this interesting result. Using fundamental principles, by looking at how the computation happens for each combinatorial problem, they discovered this result. Every problem in NP polynomially reduces to 3 sat. Very powerful result in the theory of NP completeness. What they say is, you give me any problem in NP, problems that are discovered and that are that will be discovered say 10 years later, 100 years later, look at any problem in NP, one can give a polynomial time reduction to 3 sat. In fact, they have given a framework. To that framework, if that problem is given, you get to see a reduction to 3 sat. And without assuming anything specific about the problem, the framework is designed. And so every problem in NP polynomially reduces to 3 sat. Now, as per this definition, this implies that 3 sat is NP hard. So by definition, you see that every problem in NP polynomially reduces to 3 sat. Therefore, 3 sat is NP hard. So this is the first problem that was discovered in the literature. So what is this telling us? Suppose you have problem 1, problem 2, so on up to say problem k. Each of them polynomially reduces to 3 sat. So now because of this, 3 sat is NP hard. Now we know that there is a poly time reduction to click problem which we have discussed. Now transitive relation applies. This polynomially reduces to 3 sat. With another polynomial time reduction, you go to click, which means every problem in NP polynomially reduces to click. So now every problem in NP, every NP problem polynomially reduces to click. This is how? Through transitive relation. So now this tells you that the problem click is NP hard. Then we saw that click can be polynomially reduces to independent set. This tells you that independent set is NP hard. Independent set polynomially reduces to vertex cover. So this one is NP hard. So now to show that a problem is NP hard, all that I need to do is choose one NP hard problem, any NP hard, 3 sat or this one, and give just one reduction. So we don't need to give so many reductions to our problem of interest. Choose any one known NP hard problem and give one polynomial time reduction to our problem or problem of interest. So the idea is this. So to show problem X NP hard, what are we supposed to do? Choose known NP hard problem Y and present a poly time reduction to this, which means X is NP hard. So to talk about NP hardness of problem x, choose known NP-hard problem and give a polynomial time reduction to this, which means x is NP-hard. Now you see that the power of polynomial time reduction, we don't need to give so many reductions to our problem, say vertex cover, you just give one reduction. Independent set to vertex cover, you want to show independent set is difficult, just give one reduction from click. And that's all. The transitive relationship ensures every problem in NP polynomially reduces to vertex cover. And this result is growing. So today we know that vertex cover polynomially reduces to Hamiltonian cycle, and Hamiltonian cycle polynomially reduces to Hamiltonian path. And there are many interesting results on this theory. Now there are at least 5000 problems known to be NP-hard. You solve one NP-hard problem in polynomial time. Suppose vertex cover is known to be poly, then independent set is poly, click is poly, 3-sat is poly, and every problem in NP has a polytime solution, which means P equals NP. Okay, so if VC belongs to P implies class P equals class NP. For that matter, you choose any NP-hard problem and say 10 years down the line you discover one polytime algorithm, then P equals NP. So this interesting relationship is what we infer through this theory of NP completeness. This NP-hardness theory tells you the following. If any NP-hard problem belongs to class P, then P equals NP. Because of transitive relationship, you get to see that suppose this is problem X, and now this belongs to class P, and because of this you see that P1 belongs to class P, P2 belongs to class P, so on up to PK belongs to class P. And any one NP-hard problem belongs to class P, then every problem in NP as a deterministic polytime solution. And although we don't know whether we will come up with one such algorithm in near future, but this framework is in place. The moment somebody comes up with a deterministic polytime algorithm for an NP-hard problem, this framework immediately tells you that P equals NP. Okay. And it's a different way of looking at problems when you know that problems are difficult, when we are not making progress on the complexity perspective. So now, when do we say a problem is NP complete? Okay. So to say that problem is NP complete, so to say that problem X is NP complete, we need to do two things. One, problem X belongs to NP. So present a non-deterministic algorithm for solving problem X, followed by problem X is NP-hard. Okay. So for this, discover a non-deterministic algorithm, and for this, choose any NP-hard problem, say Y, and present a poly time reduction from y to x. Over here, you just have to discover a non-deterministic algorithm. For here, you have to come up with a poly time reduction from known NP-hard problem to our problem. So this tells you that the problem that we are working with is at least as difficult as every other problem in NP, and the problem is complete for the set, meaning it belongs to the set as well, which is why it gets the name NP complete. So to say that problem is NP complete, you just have to do two things: show that it belongs to the set, and show that that problem is at least as difficult as every other problem in that set. To say that it is as difficult as every other problem in the set, you have to give so many polynomial time reduction. And to make that task easy, we say that choose one NP-hard problem and give just one poly time reduction to problem X. With this, our problem becomes NP complete. So now we know that 3SAT is in NP and NP-hard. So 3SAT belongs to NPC. Same is the case with the click, independent set, vertex cover, Hamiltonian cycle, Hamiltonian path, and they are all NP complete problems. So you choose one NP complete problem, say problem X belongs to NPC, is in say class P, maybe 10 years later, and somebody proves that a problem X belongs to NPC is in class P, implies that P equals NP, which means X is NP hard, and we know that an NP hard problem belongs to class P, then every problem in NP has a polytime solution, or P equals NP. And so the idea is to bring this framework or discover this framework so that one can compare the relative difficulty, relative hardness of these problems. And it's quite interesting that when you know you are working on a problem and you are not making a progress on say deterministic polynomial time, nor to show that no deterministic algorithm exist, and when you are in between, this theory gives you a larger message. So one can change the underlying computation, change the underlying computational model, and look at the problem from a different computational perspective, and study all those problems in a new framework or a new environment, and try relating the problems and bring in a framework. At some point in time, the problem has got an efficient solution in the old framework, which is in the deterministic world, then every problem in the new framework has got a deterministic polytime solution. And so that's the interesting part of this theory. And more details, many case studies, all that, please refer my Skype.